Welcome to the Gloucester Meetinghouse, the home of the Gloucester Unitarian Universalist Church. This wonderful building has been here at the corner of Middle and Church Streets since 1806, and it is the oldest surviving church building in Gloucester. My name is Charles Nazarian, and I'm the president of the Gloucester Meetinghouse Foundation, and it's my honor to welcome you. The foundation was formed in order to do major preservation projects on this landmark building, which is listed on the National Historic Register and has a long history in the quest for equality of all persons and the separation of church and state. And if you'd like to know more about that history, please go to our website, gloucestermeetinghouse.org, where the whole story is laid out for you. We have a couple of housekeeping things that we always need to do. One is, if you have a cell phone or something that makes noise, please take a moment to make sure that it will be silent. And if you need a lavatory, it is available through this door and at the end of the hall, or there are a few more down at the bottom of the stairs. This evening's concert is part of a series that runs from September until May every year. And we cannot put on the concerts and the events that we do without the help of our sponsors. They are listed on the back of your, on the front of your program, excuse me. And I'd like you to give them a round of applause, please. This evening you have a real treat in store. Joonho Park performed here in Gloucester in 2017. And I've traveled with him in Europe and know him well. He is a consummate musician and absolutely just wonderful person. And a pipe organ like this one, which is extremely sensitive to the touch, actually in many ways can show the personality of the player, and I think that will come through for you this evening, in especially in the repertoire that he's chosen. You can see Joonho's background story on the backside of your programs. He lives in Korea, where he teaches at two universities, but he is also an adjunct professor at the University of Texas at Austin. And he's on an international tour at the moment, and his next stop is the cathedral in England at St. Albans. So I get to send him off on the airplane tomorrow evening with regrets. The instrument that you hear tonight was built in 1893 by George Hutchings. And George Hutchings was considered the premier organ builder of the Boston area, really of New England, during that period. And he went on to build the first organ in Symphony Hall in Boston in 1903. This instrument has what is called mechanical key action, or is sometimes called tracker action, which means that when you press the key, you are actually moving a mechanical linkage that lets the wind into the pipes. And when I say that somebody's personality can come through in their playing, it's because the way one touches the key and releases it affects how the pipes speak. And they can be made to be extremely chiffy or strong in their speech, or they can also be made extremely smooth and legato, just depending upon what the organist does with his hands and with his feet. This evening, Joonho has chosen a very ambitious program, which involves quite a few changes in registration or stops of the organ. And some organs, especially modern ones, have a solid state system in which the player can simply press a button and go from one set of sounds to the other. We haven't quite made it to that point yet. So there are mechanical devices for putting the stops on and off. And we're very fortunate this evening to have Andy Soul with us, who is acting as Joonho's registrant, or that is combination action. And so you'll probably see Andy go going to one side or the other and putting some stops on and off in order to produce the sounds that the music deserves. Something else that you should know about this instrument is that it was refurbished in 1962 by Charles Fisk, the organ builder here in Gloucester, who is world renowned for his mechanical action instruments, and especially for instruments that emulated various period styles and of different countries. But Charles also loved the sound of New England organs of the 19th century. And he restored many instruments by the Hooks and by others. And he learned through that process how the New England organ builders voice their instruments to sound good in New England rooms, which are not usually like rooms in Europe where there is a large reverberation time. Most of our rooms are acoustically a little bit on the dry side. You don't hear a long decay of sound. And he greatly admired what the New England organ builders did. However, when he refurbished this instrument in 1962, it was very much the beginning of the Baroque revival. And so in some very subtle ways, he took the voicing of Hutchings' work and maintained it, but gave it a little bit more brilliance so that one could play the works of Bach with a little bit more historic authority, one might say. But he did not remove any of the warm foundation stops or the romantic sounds of the instrument. And so we're blessed with an instrument that can play many, many different periods of music. And that's what you're going to hear this evening. So I'd like to welcome Joonho Park. Please give him a large round of applause.
Thank you. just need to work on that. Yeah.